Okay. I have another question because I'm traveling frequently and let's say during travel I lost my disk. How would like you as a hacker recover the data from that disk? Is it difficult?
I don't need to hack it. I don't need to hack it because data is there unencrypted. I simply recover it using available software. I recover the data because it's not even properly deleted, you know. It's just there, like the disk I bought, this one, I brought it here, I bought it secondhand. The data was unencrypted, was properly deleted once, not properly, so I easily recovered using the software that is available on the market for recovering, so zero effort. I don't need to hack it, therefore, no hacking, I'm clear.
Okay, yeah. Good. See, you need to encrypt your data. If you don't encrypt your data might be compromised once you lose access to your disk, once you lost the disk. So please take care and protect your data by encrypting the disk. Keep it safe. Take care. I bought the second-hand USB drive. I'm going to check if I can recover some data from that USB drive. Here I select the pictures. I want to recover pictures. I will specify the letter that was assigned by system. And I am starting. Here it asked me for deep scan, yes, and it started. I'm not going to wait till the end. I will stop this process right now to see if something got recovered. There is one file. I will select recover highlighted and specify the same drive. Okay, there is a warning, but yes, data got recovered. I can open the file right now and see the data from previous user. In order to discuss this encryption, I will simplify it and divide it in two cases. First case is when I bought brand new disk. It's not encrypted, it doesn't contain any data, so I can encrypt it and start putting data on it. Or I don't care about the existing data on my own disk because the data is not important, the data is not confidential. Second case is when the data that I have on my disk is important for me and I wanted to encrypt it. And due to some reasons, I forgot to do it before, but I want to be safe from now and I want to keep my data encrypted. That won't be possible for anyone else to read it. To encrypt the disk with existing data, first make an encrypted backup to the secondary location, any available place. And secondly, run the encryption to encrypt the data in place. I will start creating volume for backup, so it will be encrypted file container. I will choose a standard VeraCrypt volume and select the file. Here I will choose a name for that file. It will be pendrive underscore backup. Save. Now, next, accept the encryption options and choose a size of that volume. Size should be more than the data that exists already on the pen drive, so 1 megabyte is enough. I need to generate a password. In order to do that, I will create a new database for KeePass, accept the default name and set up the strong master password. These are the default settings. I will skip. And under the Windows, I will create a new entry. Here I specify the name for that entry, VeraCrypt underscore pendrive underscore backup. And then I will create the password using the password generator. In password generator, I will specify 21 chars and special chars to be included. Okay, now copy that password, place it under the password boxes and next. Now move a mouse very quickly for some time Okay, and format. Format was done, the volume was created. Now I can exit that wizard. Let's cancel. Okay, now I will mount created volume. So I will go to that file, choose a file, open it, and click on mount. Now I need to provide the password I saved in KeePass. So I'll copy that password again, place it here, and click on K. Okay, volume was mounted. So I can now I can copy the data from the pen drive to that volume. So volume is encrypted, so it's encrypted backup of the pen drive data. Once it's done, I can create the in place encrypted volume on the pen drive. So I would choose here the location of the partition on the pen drive, click next, and change the option to encrypt partition in place. Okay, yes, I have a backup. I'll accept the settings and specify a new password. I'll duplicate this entry and then change the password. Okay, edit entry. Change the name without backup, suffix, and here I just refresh the password like that. Okay, copy that password, place it, and click next. Now again, moving mouse activity. Okay, it was now a wipe mode. I will choose a one iteration, but you can choose even 35 iterations. To have it fast, I will choose one pass. Next. Okay, accept the questions and encrypt. Yes. Okay, now it will take some time until it's done. Few hours, I will speed it up on the video. And after a few hours, it's done. So it will display the instructions, how to use it. I'll click finish. Okay, now let's click on auto mount devices and I will provide the password that I save in KeePass database. Okay. Encrypted volume is mounted, so I can open it and I can see the data, exactly the same data that was on the pen drive. So it was encrypted in place. I can dismount it. Another situation is when I have a brand new disk and I want to encrypt it before putting data on it. Or if I don't care about the data, so I can override the data and create a new volume on that pen drive. It's simpler because I can create the volume here, choose a non-system partition drive, yes, and select VeraCrypt volume, select the partition, click next, keep this option create encrypted volume and format it. I will accept the settings, yes, the whole partition, and here I will use the same password that I used before for encryption. Okay, I'll keep it as default over here. Another moving mouse activity and format. There is a warning about risk of losing the data. I will accept it. Okay, this takes too much time, so I will abort it and switch to the quick format. Quick format is enough because I don't care about data, I don't care. Okay, quick format, yes, I will accept the risk. And it's quick, it's taking a couple of seconds. Yes, it's done. Instruction how to use it. Okay, it's done. I can exit the wizard and mount that created volume by clicking auto mount devices and providing the password into the form. Okay. For a moment, the volume was mounted. I can open it and I can create the new file in that mount, those secret file. Now I can dismount it, going dismount it, and I can mount it again to simulate that I unplug and plug in pen drive. I'll use the same password and it's mounted. Again, I can open it and see the file I created.